I'm Jennifer Anger. I'm in the Department of Urology, also in OBGYN as an adjunct professor. I study reproductive age women, both cis and trans women, and I study incontinence in aging women, as well as prostate cancer in aging women. Wink, wink. So today we're going to talk about interstitial cystitis and how we can use VA data sets to study women. This is a great example of how thinking that IC is a women's disease has stifled research in IC, and it actually has impacted the care for both men and women with IC. And the VA is a great place to study all populations. We have some gender-affirming care studies of veterans. And what's neat about it is you can have an administrative data set, which largely focus on only claims, but then we can go into the charts from identifying patients by claims data. So it makes it very novel. So as many of you know, painful bladder syndrome is unidentified or without other causes. Painful bladder, symptoms of bladder pain that it lasts at least 6 weeks in origin without causes such as a UTI. Classically, it's been said that 10 women to every one man have IC, but looking at VA data, we actually, with rigorous chart review, found that this ratio is only 1.6 to 1. And there's many gaps in care. We don't know what causes it. We really don't know how to treat it. Women are considered crazy. And so we're trying to understand roles of predictive that can predict outcomes, for example, PTSD, depression. And actually what we want to study are certain characteristics. How does exercise impact pain? Or how does pain impact our ability to exercise? So doing some work looking at including Fitbits. Also determining the impact of comorbid conditions such as depression, such as PTSD, which is higher in the veteran population on symptoms of bladder pain. And then also assessing the effect of possible disparities. Wait, we'll get off of this slide real quick. No, just kidding. We really do want to continue to study disparities. You know, there's this, you know, we've been kind of confusing DEI from disparities research, but what we really want to do is identify patients at higher risk of certain conditions. And we want to also be advocates for all of our patients. So here what we want to look at is, and some great work's been done, it might be temporarily halted in several areas of research, but looking at the role of area code, or what we call area deprivation index, not just the area code, but that 10-digit area code or neighborhood. How does that impact pain? What's really interesting is a vast majority in of patients, so women in on Long Island, 90% of women Caucasian had pain, who had painful bladder syndrome diagnosis of IC, actually had significant dietary sensitivity, meaning they would say, this bothers my bladder, this bothers my bladder. And so and so we're thinking, well, is this isolated to women? Is it women are thinking that their diet is bothering them when really it's not? And we actually looked at the same thing in men and women, a very heterogeneous population, racially and ethnically diverse population, and they also had very significant dietary sensitivity. So this is a sort of example where we want to really study both men and women, and then we can better identify diseases and hopefully help patients of both genders or all genders. Thank you so much.